put down the guns, young people. There it is. And 4 years ago, I heard about this man that's sitting here with me. And I called him up, and we've been friends for 4 years.
That's
God
right.
Bless you.
Thank you.
And Jack Logan, he founded Put Down the Guns, Young People. And this is a man that doesn't talk and do. He goes in and does what needs to be done. He doesn't just tell people about it, he does it. And you started yourself going into neighborhoods and talking to young people, and probably neighborhoods that I might feel a little uneasy about going into. And you try to help kids see a better way.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. And you're growing.
Yes, ma'am, we are. We are, our message is out there, and God has us covered.
You've said it all. And you went to Chicago. You just got home. Why did you go?
Miss Denny, sitting up on, looking at the internet, watching little small children, watching little boys hold up signs written on a piece of pasteboard box saying, "Don't shoot me." That was very touching to me. In July, this month here, there were so many people killed at the very beginning of this month, and it has continued like every other day in Chicago. I feel that the government there, the activists there, they're not walking the walk.
No.
They're not walking the walk. And I put in my mind, and I prayed about it, I said, I'm going to do the same format that I do in the state of South Carolina, walk the walk. And people, even policemen here, told me, Jack, that's very dangerous. Different business people.
Some people have said that the police will not go into some of these neighborhoods.
Well, even when I talked to the police there prior to going, they told me that to be careful.
But you went.
But I went and walked those streets that
and
some of
them. And you talked to these kids? What did you find?
Well, the first sad story, like I told you when I walked in, the first kid that we approached, I was going to take a picture of him. He walked by and he went on to the Subway shopping. He got him a sub sandwich. He walked back down and I stopped him. And I gave him some literature and held maybe a 2-minute conversation with him. And I told him to stay in school. He told me he played baseball on his school team. Well, and thereafter that Friday, we talked to so many other kids and along the way in some bad neighborhoods. But the saddest thing was Friday night, sitting back at the hotel, when I watch ABC 7 from Chicago, that first kid that I talked to was gunned down.
Oh, dear God.
He was gunned down, and some more of them were shot. Sitting watching Friday night, that same news, telling about a 3-year-old boy outside at 10 p.m. on a porch with his mother was shot in the head. As of this day, he is in ICU there at Mount Sinai Hospital in Chicago.
Now, this is certain areas of Chicago.
Right. And, the west side and the south side.
And it's just lawless.
Right. I don't know. I had been warned from the police and other people that I would recognize the difference of sides of town. About when you get to certain sides that you can't just walk into a restaurant. You can't just walk into a convenience store. I slipped and forgot about that.
What do you mean, Jack?
You can't go in because of the danger of those sides of town. So when we got over on those sides of town, I went to some of those convenience stores. I went to some of those restaurants. It still didn't dawn in my head that this, how bad it was. But that didn't stop us. We walked down the streets. We stopped young kids. They looked at my shirt that said, "Put down the guns, young people." And one guy, I said to him, "Please don't shoot me." When I turned my back, he said, "I'm not going to shoot you. You're not here to hurt me. You're here to help me." I felt overjoyed. I didn't want to leave from time to come because I felt so sorry for those children and teens there who have guns, who looked in the poverty level.
And it's like they're killing their own people.
Right. And what has happened, I feel they have lost, don't have anyone to love them. The parenting at home, and they just have meanness unless someone come along and show them love. And, you know, I don't have much money. I was just nice to them. And it was the grace of God. They didn't shoot me and Brian, the other.
You had somebody with you.
Right. And it was the grace of God, we didn't get shot.
Did the police know that you were there?
They knew. That I talked to them on telephone prior to us going. We saw policemen just sitting around. The funniest thing to me, when I was going to go into the barbershop there, and I thought I could just open the door and go in, it wasn't like that. I had to buzz in to get their attention. And then when I walked in, the barber said to me, he said, what do you need? I said, I want to get a haircut. He said, you don't need a haircut. I said, yes, I need a haircut. So we sit down. They never asked the other guy, because my shirt, he didn't have on the put down the guns t-shirt. I think that they thought, and he think that they thought he was from Chicago showing me around. Uh-huh. And because he owned a long white t-shirt that most guys wear up there. And so I went in, I got a haircut, and at that time I told them what we do, and everybody there was, they welcomed us. We were, we got in the car, and finally we left the south side. We're riding by some park, and we saw a lot of people, so we stopped. And I walked up to the guy, and I told him, who was at the place where the music was being played. He said, you do what? He said, you're not afraid up here? He said, I've got to let you address these teens. It was a black cowboy event where a bunch of black people been doing for 20 years, riding horses, and they had that day set just for teens. And I got to address the teens about gun violence and to stay in school and get an education. And we were well received on the bad side, and we stayed at Overbrook Village out there, which is a very upscale part of Chicago. And even those people, we put our banner up on that side, and those people were stopping, appreciating us for what we're doing. We were well welcomed there in Chicago. But what bothers me, and I'm very outspoken about this, not picking on the President of the United States, but he's from Chicago.
Yeah.
And the mayor there, for the mayor to let those children live in poverty and have a plan to bring those kids from the border, 1,000 kids, that is sad, and he's not taking care of the children right there in Chicago who's in poverty and walking around with guns in their pockets.
The mayor of Chicago wants to bring some of these refugees or people who cross the border illegally to add to whatever is problems
right.
are already there.
Right.
But he wants to, it makes him look good. Let's be
right.
honest.
It makes him look
it's
good.
It's all about me.
Right. Like he cares for people. He needs to care for those people there in Chicago, in the city of Chicago, and President Obama needs to go to Chicago, not so much of putting those little children in jail. There's forces out here who can get those guns out of the hands of those children, because this thing will expand into Illinois and to the rest of the world.
Yeah,
because
sure.
And I just hope and pray that the children in South Carolina do not adapt to what's going on in Chicago, because
we have gangs here.
Right.
We have right here in the upstate.
Right.
And people need to be aware of what's going on.
That's right.
And I don't know what we can do, but obviously it's out of control in Chicago. You can't really blame the law enforcement people.
No, you cannot blame
for not wanting to walk into those streets.
Right. Right. It goes back to the leaders there in Chicago, and I have to go back to the White House administration. If we can go to Afghanistan and worry about problems over there, we can take care of Chicago, Illinois.
I'm sorry, but to me, you take care of your own
right.
first.
That's absolutely
and
right.
And we don't do that.
Right.
Now, you've been very good with what you have accomplished with very little funding
right
here in Greenville, South Carolina.
Right.
You've done
right.
some wonderful things.
And this summer here in Greenville, and people, there has been no gun violence downtown in the city of Greenville. Even I was in Chicago this past week. We had people from our organization still downtown on the streets of downtown Greenville preventing gun violence among teens, and no curfew violations. Interim Chief Mike Gambrell, he was not chosen to be the permanent chief.
He's a good man.
But he have done a good job this summer downtown Greenville, and we have been down there working hard. This will be our 14th week coming up.
Now, we have a curfew, don't we,
Jack? We do have a curfew at 10 o'clock.
At 10 o'clock, so that what age group? After that, they're not supposed to be
18. You have to be under the age of
18. If you're under 18, you're not supposed to be out and about in downtown Greenville after
10 o'clock. But what we have witnessed, parents pulling up there as if the police officers are babysitters, putting the kids out at 9:30. I mean, and driving off or leaving the children. And then, but we worked hard to make sure that those kids, you know, get off the streets by 10. So, because our thing is, we don't want to see a child parent cited with curfew violations, trying to save the child from going to jail. And we've been blessed so far. And but the most significant thing, compared to last summer, there have been no gun violence in the city.
Well,
of
you
Greenville,
go yourself down there and walk
right.
around and talk to people
right.
and talk to kids that you
right.
see out.
That's right. That's right. We prevented a big, could have gotten out of hand about 3 weeks ago downtown, where two sets of gangs was going to fight, when I could not get, I called dispatch. I don't know what the communication failed to prevent an innocent person from being shot, possibly. I just stepped in between the two gangs and told one gang member to hit his crotch to follow me back down the sidewalk, and they did. At that time, I spoke to Officer Bowser for the Greenville City Police Department, and he more or less escorted them on away from downtown.
Yeah.
And
so,
we've been blessed.
But there's a lot of work to be done.
There's a lot of work to be done, but it starts at home, and it starts with the Bible.
And a lot of these kids, and especially you're talking about Chicago, they have no home life.
They have
no mother or father.
That's right.
And especially the fathers.
Right, right.
They absentee have no fathers.
They have no home. I just, if I had $1 million, I might have built an apartment complex. I have a home for you right there in Chicago. That's how bad I felt for those little children. I've never witnessed little children.
And they
in the
have
street.
No parents?
There was no, I mean.
The mother, they don't even have a mother?
Those kids told me they live in the street. They live in the street. That's what bothered me so much about the government there in Chicago and the White House administration.
Well, yeah. But we can't solve everybody's problems.
Right.
But what we can do is support Jack Logan and the people who work with him, however we can, to make our area of the United States safe. Now,
that's
do
right.
we have Spartanburg and Lawrence, all these different areas close to us?
Right.
Do you have an outreach to any of those places?
I go and we travel all over the state of South Carolina. Matter of fact, this week we've got to get down to Dorchester County. That's in Charleston. Gun violence is beginning to get bad there. Among young people. We're going down there and do the same thing we did in Chicago and do the same thing. We've been there before, but we got to go back.
Now, I know that you need funding.
Right.
But do you have fundraisers or what? I mean.
Well, you know, we haven't asked anyone for a dime.
I know that. I know you haven't.
We haven't asked anyone for a dime. The people over at American Security, Henry Harris and them, they helped fund us to Chicago. And the rest of the money came out of our pocket. And we don't beg for money. We scrap it up ourselves. Not saying that we wouldn't take any, but we just don't go and ask for money. Other organizations do that. Put Down the Guns, Young People Organization. From day one, I told them we would not do that. We would
okay.
not do that.
So
if someone want to help us buy T-shirts, they can write a check to the
So you give these T-shirts,
give
you
away.
Go into these neighborhoods
right.
and talk to these kids and you give them these
right.
T-shirts?
Right. And if anyone want to buy a quantity of T-shirts, they welcome to call me up and I will tell them where to go and, you know, the company that we use. Or if they want to pay for an additional billboard, they're $635 for 1 year to get our message out. And I do believe that the billboards up in the upstate of South Carolina is having a big impact on our children not picking up a gun.
Do you have regular places where you have rallies or something
like,
where somebody could come?
We do. We use different recreation centers, and they just have to go to our website and keep up with it. And that's on, well, that's Facebook. We have a Facebook page,
okay.
Put Down the Guns, Young People.
And I have Jack's number, and we have it, hopefully we'll put it on the screen, 864-303-1030. And I'll keep that number here. Maybe you own a business. Maybe you're a company out there and you say, hey, I could do something. I could buy 100 T-shirts.
Right.
We can all do something. And I admire what you have accomplished so far. Mm-hmm. And I think you're beginning to be noticed.
Right.
That what yes, you're
now
doing.
I'm wondering, I said, gosh, do I need a secretary? Because my telephone rings constantly, you know, and emails, and I be tired, I admit. But Jesus don't get tired. He's 24/7, and that's the way I look at that. And I will go back to Chicago. I'm not done with Chicago. I will go back there within 30 days.
But it's such an overwhelming situation. You say, how can one or two people make a difference?
Right.
And but if we the have, people in Chicago don't care.
They don't care. I mean, they don't care to
but
me.
But you don't
me.
Find that here.
Right. People here care. You know, they do. People in this state care. Our governor, she cares about. We were just honored at the State House about 3 weeks ago, Representative Chandra Dillard. All the both Democrat and Republicans lawmakers honored us for the work that we do in this state.
Well, God bless you. And I will keep the information here. And if you want to get involved, put down the guns, young people. If you just want to buy one T-shirt, it's okay too.
That's right.
Jack,
okay.
God bless you.
Thank you. And thank
you for
having
us. Keep us posted,
okay?
Wherever you are, if you have kids at home, talk to them. Stay close. We'll see you next time.